Morning. Today we are going to start the CPU scheduling topic in its detail. In our last class, we tried to understand some concepts of schedulers. As you know, that in operating system, there is a module which is responsible for scheduling the different jobs at their different components, particularly on the processor at their different requirements. The CPU scheduler, let us have some recap of your last class so that we may extend that up to that our today's topic, that is called CPU scheduling. As you know, that when you submit your job to the system for its a processing purpose, for its computing purpose, first it goes to a buffer memory. First it gets stored in a temporary storage where it first gets stored in a buffer memory. This is the buffer memory. And your all jobs that is submitted for its processing gets stored here in this buffer memory. From this buffer storage, your long-term scheduler, picks the similar nature of the similar kinds of jobs or the jobs which require similar kinds of processing, and creates their batches. It is the duty of long-term scheduler to create different batches of the jobs that may be of similar processing requirement. From this long-term scheduler, when it has already created their batches, its job is to create the batches and to hand over that batches to the short-term scheduler. The short-term scheduler then picks a particular batch or any batch from these bunches of the batches, and then it schedules the jobs individually that is present in that batch and sends them to the processor for their processing. The jobs available or present in a particular batch are scheduled individually by the short-term scheduler. This short-term scheduler is also known as CPU scheduler. It is called CPU scheduler because it schedules the jobs at their individual level just before their entry into the processor. That's why it is called the CPU scheduler, just before their entry into the CPU. In normal circumstances, when a job enters into the processor, it gets processed, and after the completion of their processing, it gets exit. But in the meantime, if a job needs some kind of input output requirements, it is preempted. If that job needs a kind of a input output requirements during their processing, it is not straight back into that processor, and it is preempted from the processor to a buffer space, and there it completes its input output requirements. There it completes its input-output requirements. In the meantime, the processor accepts the next job which is scheduled for their processing and resides still in that space where that short-term scheduler has scheduled them. When this input-output need of the job that is preempted or that is evacuated from the processor is complete, that job is again rescheduled, or it is again sent back to the queue for the rescheduling, and this is done by medium term scheduler. So this is the entire sketch. Try to understand when you submit a job for its processing or for its computation, first it gets stored into a buffer memory. From that buffer memory, this long-term scheduler picks the similar nature of similar kinds of jobs and creates their batches, or that picks the jobs which requires both kind of computing needs, like some jobs which is mostly needed the input output components, or some jobs which is mostly CPU bound. And that is the objective of this long term scheduler is to create a proper mix, or to create a balanced batch where both kinds of jobs may be collected. And then long term scheduler, which creates their batches, hands over those batches to the short term scheduler. Short term scheduler picks any one of the batch from that bunch, and it schedules the jobs individually that is available in that batch. Means which job it will get the processor first and for how long time. Then it enters as per their scheduling into the processor and gets processed according to their instructions and data, and exits the system. But if in the meanwhile, while it's processing, if it requires any input output requirements, it is evacuated from the processor, and the processor accepts the next job which is scheduled after that job in that scheduling, and it is stored temporarily in a buffer memory where it fulfills its input output requirements. And when that input output requirement is complete, it is again rescheduled by the medium term scheduler. So this is the relation between all these three kinds of scheduler: long term scheduler, short term scheduler, and medium term scheduler. And this is their particular job or objective. Now this short term scheduler becomes little more interesting and more important, as this short term scheduler is also known as CPU scheduler, because it is called CPU scheduler because it schedules the jobs individually just before their entry into the CPU or the processor. Now the CPU scheduler or the short term scheduler, which schedules these jobs individually, do not schedule them without any regulation or without any algorithm. It do not schedules any job just as discretionary. It schedules according to a particular rule, a particular logic, or particular algorithm. Those algorithms which is adopted by these this short-term scheduler or CPU scheduler is known as CPU scheduling algorithms. So now have a look on that most popularly used CPU scheduling algorithms. See, in modern world we are using most complex systems. We are not only using the multi-programming operating system, multitasking operating system, multi-threading operating system, multi-processing operating system, multi-user system, but God knows how much multi world we have entrusted with our new systems. It is being utilized to process each and every kind of job that can happen in this world. So in such case, a complex system may have a complex scheduling algorithm. But most popularly there are some scheduling algorithms. There are five types of scheduling algorithms that are most popularly used worldwide. But even then, I may explain this and make clear this to you, that it entirely depends upon the designers of the systems and the requirements of the systems and the need of the system, or the system where it has to be used, and it is going to be used in the organization according to that the need of that organization. It may be designed by the designers of the system, but most popularly we use five kinds of scheduling algorithms. Among them, one of the scheduling algorithm is known as first come first serve. It is known as first come first serve. Let us have in that shortcut. As the name itself suggests, this scheduling algorithm is first come first serve. It serves according to this algorithm, the different jobs that is scheduled to be processed and that is scheduled to that has to be scheduled to send to the processor for its processing is done on the basis of this first come first serve. It means the job which arrives first will get the services of the processor first. So according to their first come first serve policy, the job is scheduled according to their arrival time. Another popular method that is mostly used is shortest job first. In this algorithm, whatever the job is available in that ready queue with the short-term scheduler, the scheduler schedules those jobs according to their processing time, according to their processing requirements. The job which requires the shortest time or which is shortest in their length is going to be scheduled first in this algorithm. One thing I must like to clear here in between this detailing of the scheduling that you cannot say that a particular scheduling algorithm is better or it is best and a particular is worst or bad. No scheduling algorithm can be treated as best or worst or bad or anything else. It depends entirely on that set of job that is to be processed. In a particular set of job, a particular types of scheduling algorithm may give a better result, and in another set of job, that scheduling algorithm may perform very worse. So do not consider these scheduling algorithms in that understanding that it is the best or worst. Every scheduling algorithm has its own advantages and its own disadvantages. Now, the third kind of scheduling algorithm that is most popularly used is round robin. It is round robin. In this scheduling algorithm, the jobs are scheduled according to a particular time quantum. Whatever the job is available in that ready queue, the scheduler first analyzes their entire time requirement to process all those jobs and then creates a particular time quantum, and accordingly it provides a particular time slice to a particular job, then it preempts that job and admits the another job, and again it preempts that job and admits the another. By such means, it creates a round robin situation in which every job gets a particular time quantum or time slice to be processed. The fourth kind of scheduling algorithm that is popularly used in some specialized kinds of systems is priority-based preemptive scheduling. It is priority-based preemptive scheduling. It is normally used in such systems where time is the most precious factor, where you cannot afford to lose even a fraction of a second for any kind of allotment of the processors. It is priority-based. It is used mostly in the real-time systems where time is most precious, where time is most critical. Such as in defense sectors and in atomic energies and in space explorations. The fifth kind of scheduling algorithm that is most popularly used is multi-level queuing. Nowadays, this multi-level queuing is most happening scheduling algorithm in most of the systems, and most of the modern systems utilize this, the benefits and advantages of this multi-level queuing. Now, let us have their advantages and disadvantages one by one. First, today we try to take the first come first serve scheduling algorithm. in first come first scheduling algorithm. In this algorithm, as the name itself suggests, it schedules according to their arrival time. Let us have a look at their working methods. Before I go to this first come first serve, I wish to clear one another concept that is used in this scheduling concepts. Most of the writers or most of the publishers have a kind of a concept that explains that every scheduling algorithm, they divide these schedulings into two categories. One is called preemptive scheduling and another is called non-preemptive scheduling. As the name itself suggests that preemptive scheduling is such kind of scheduling in which once the processor is allocated to a particular job, that process may be preempted, may be evacuated, may be expelled from that processor at any point of time if a particular situation arrives or if a particular need is required. That job may be preempted, that may be evacuated due to any reason, due to any logical reason. But in non-preemptive scheduling algorithms, if once the processor is allocated to a particular job for its processing, it cannot be evacuated in any condition. It cannot be evacuated. The job will complete its processing and then only it will exit the processor. So all these processing algorithms can also be judged with such concepts of preemptive and non-preemptive. Most of the writers or the publishers have of this opinion that these jobs can be clearly categorized under these two categories. But in my opinion, no job in this modern systems can be categorized for all the time in a preemptive category or in non-preemptive category. It entirely depends upon that situation, and it is not possible to categorize a particular scheduling algorithm in a particular category for all its time. But for understanding of this concept, you may take this first come first serve scheduling algorithm as non-preemptive in nature. Once it is scheduled, it cannot be preempted until it completes its processing, till it completes its computation, and only then it will exit that processor. This first-come-first scheduling algorithm, which is non-preemptive in nature, is entirely based on their arrival time. If in a system multiple jobs arrives for their processing, if in a ready queue multiple jobs are present for their processing, like job 1, job 2, job 3, job 4, then it becomes most pertinent to decide that which job should get entry into the processor for its processing from these all set of jobs. There, the scheduling algorithm or the scheduler decides the allotment of this processor according to their arrival time. The job which arrives at what moment of time will be decided, at what moment of time will become the basis for their decision to get their time allotment in the processor. If a job arrives at the zero time, it will be scheduled first. If the job, it will be scheduled next, it will be scheduled third, and it will be scheduled fourth. Let us have a rest for today. We will explain this first come first scheduling algorithm in detail in our next video class. Thank you.